What's up guys, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to animate inside Blockbench and then transfer it into MC Creator. In my last video I showed you how to animate an item, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to animate an entity recommended by this guy shown on screen. He asked me to make a video and I said yeah, sure. So before we get started, I just want to let you know that I haven't been recording videos because I had school, but summer break starts at the 14th, and I'm going to basically have all the time in the world to make videos or have fun basically. Yeah, let's begin. So, I'm not going to be telling you what does what in details, but basically I'm just going to tell you a little bit of everything. Like you just need I'm just going to tell you everything you need to know about it. Okay, so now go to File, Plugin, go to Available and search GeckoLib. After you do that, press install and go to, again, after you installed GeckoLib, go to File. Okay, now go to File, New, and press on GeckoLib Animated Model. Now, name the file whatever you want. For this entity, I'm going to be naming it Bob. Let's say Bob. Okay. The model identifier is basically what what Minecraft recognizes, like what kind of model it is. Basically, if the model identifier is some sort of a name that already exists in item or a model, entity, stuff like that, then they're going to collide and probably break the game. And I say. And when I say break the game, I mean basically just crash the game. So make a new name, a name that vanilla Minecraft doesn't use, which I'm going to be using Bob. Hello guys, and I'm currently editing this video. I just want to mention if paint and animate don't show up, or you have multiple like paint, animate, display, then your model is not going to work. So to fix that, go to File, GeckoLib Model Settings, and the object type needs to be entity. So not to be so not armor, not block slash item, but entity. So yeah. Keep in mind that and do it, and yeah. So, on with the video. Okay, now that we're done, we can begin with, but before that, just to let you know, because when we go to animate, you're probably, for my animations, they're going to be simpler, but if you want, you can add multiple groups into multiple groups. So for example, if I do something like this, bone, so make a new group and put all of them inside that group. Okay, and I'm going to be naming this bone. It can stay bone, but I want it to be organized, so I'm going to be calling it Bob model. Okay, now let's start. So the first thing you want to know is north. This is where your model is going to look. So it's your model, your entity is going to look towards this way. But yeah, so let's begin. And that's basically it for a model. Now let's go to paint. So select the model first of all and press create texture. I'm going to be naming that my texture Bob. Bob texture. Sure. And it's going to be, yeah, that's good. That's good enough. And I'm going to actually just be making this. I mean, it's not bad, but yeah, it's just a model. I'm going to give it some fingers, red fingers, yep. And red toes. Sure. You know, I know it's a derpy model, but it's going to finish the job. So, let's begin. When I say let's begin, I mean let's start with animating. Okay, so now that we have created our model, we have created a texture. Now let's move on to animate. So add an animation, and I'm going to be making two animations, a walk animation and an idle animation. An idle animation basically means so if you're making an idle animation, then make it a loop mode. So an idle animation basically means what the model does when it's not doing anything. It's not moving, it's just staying in one spot. And before I start with animating, I forgot to mention one thing. So to basically animate groups, you're going to have to be making a pivot point, or you don't have to, but it's pretty much necessary. Like, for example, if I want to move the head, I'm going to be starting from here. That's why it's better if we just move the pivot point. So you can either press P, as you can see here, either P or just here, pivot point. Okay, now move either now press center pivot point, and just move it according to where you think it should be. For example, I think it should be here, the head, the pivot point. The body is just going to be centered. Right leg is that leg, so I'm just going to be centering it and moving it one block up. Left leg, again the same thing, and the arms, I'm going to be making them here on top. For example, as you can see, this is exactly where I want it to be. Now do the same for the right leg, for the right arm, and yeah. Okay, and now if you go back to the animate section, you can see that it's way more easier to animate. So let's start. Idle animation, I just want the for Bob to, let's say, breathe. So I'm just going to make something like this. Before starting any animation, if you want it to look smooth, then you're going to have to be making a first position. For this, I'm just going to be making, because I'm editing scale, I'm just going to press on body, scale here, one plus, and that basically means there's the starting animation. I'm just going to move the timer, the timeline, and make a change to the model, and as you can see, these white diamonds, let's say, are basically keyframes or frames, and when the timeline goes on top of when the timeline goes past them, it basically animates. As you can see, that I made this frame to be here, and this frame to be here. The body should be expanded. So now if I play the animation, you can see that he's breathing, but as you can see, it's not smooth. So I can just press on the frame here at the starting frame, Control C, and just paste it at one half a second. So now, as you can see, he breathes like this. In the game, he's going to look something like this, which is not bad. Okay, now that we have made our idle animation, let's begin with our walk animation. Walk animation, and this needs to be looped as well. Okay, and for the walk animation, I just want the first of all, as I told you, to make a smooth animation, you're going to be making a first keyframe at the start. So let's find the left leg, here it is. And just because I'm editing the rotation, I'm just going to be pressing on rotation and moving to a quarter of a second and moving it something like this. Then copying the first frame, pasting it on a half a second, and then on a, I forgot what it's called, on seven, on dot, on this second, I'm just going to be moving it something like this. And now, as you can see, he moves something like that. And on the last second, I'm just going to return it. And as you can see, the leg is smooth. It's smoothly walking. Okay, now let's do the same on here. So if we go back here, let's first of all make the rotation, first position, move it to whatever time we want. We're going to be copying this, pasting it here, doing the opposite on this side, and just basically doing the, yeah. Okay, so that's basically it for the walking animation. Now, as we can see, the walking animation is finished. So now let's import it into MC Creator. So go to File, Export, and then Export GeckoLib Model. Now you can either make a file or just save it to wherever you want to, but make it a place where you can access it easily. So make a new folder and place your, I'm just going to be making a folder, but you can place it whatever, wherever you want to. Okay, now save the animations. And last but not least, save the texture. Okay, now don't close Blockbench just yet, because the names will be important later. So now open MC Creator. Okay, now that you have opened MC Creator, you need to first of all have the plugin installed. I'm not going to be showing you how to install the plugin in this video, but you can check out my previous video. So yeah, just create a new workspace, and name it whatever you want to. I'm just going to be naming it Bob Mod. Yeah, Bob Mod. Okay, so I'll be back when the workspace is finished. I'll see you. Okay, now after your workspace is loaded, we can go ahead and go to workspace settings, external APIs, check this box, and save changes. It's going to show up a, do you want to refactor the mods or like the workspace? You can either press yes or no, it doesn't really matter. So yeah, save changes. After that loads, go to resources, gecko lib, and then import gecko lib model. Now go where you previously saved it and sorry, go to the file that you previously saved, where you previously saved it, click on it and press open. Now it's going to ask you for the animation. So yeah, exactly, go to animation and everything should be good to go. Now go to mode element and click on the green plus and press E, or press the fourth one, animated entity. Now name this whatever you want to. I'm just going to be naming it Bob. So yeah, create Bob, create an entity, and this is where the second one is basically where you put your model. So yeah, put your model, and on the 1, 2, 3, 4, on the fifth one there should be texture entity. Now you can press on the plus and just go to the texture you saved for the model entity. Now go to the slide down and select your texture. Now there is entity model that basically means the visual scale, the bounding box scale, that basically means the hitbox and how big your character is going to look like, how big your character is going to be. So for right now I'm not going to mess with these settings, but yeah, so I'm not, for right now I'm not going to mess with these settings. Now if you have something you want to change or add, that's completely fine, like glow texture, entity model, bounding box and stuff like that. I'm going to edit two things, and that's basically the behavior. It's not going to be aggressive, but it's going to be a creature. And yeah, the default mob drop is going to be none. Or not, I'm just going to be adding a diamond block, sure. Okay, and let's go to spawning, enable spawning, and I'm just going to uncheck that. And the final thing is going to the animations and entering the name. So as I said previously, do not close the block bench because you're going to be needing it. Now open block bench, go to animate and go to idle animation. Now the name you can just copy, you can press either confirm or cancel, whatever you want to, and go to animation name for idle animation and just paste it. So you can see there's a check and it says this input field is valid. Now you can check all of these if you have the animations for them, for example swimming animation and walking animation, death animation and so on. I do have walking animation, so I'm just going to be enabling that and go back to block bench, go to the desired animation, copy the name and paste it where you need to. For me it's going to be below walking animation, and that's it. Yeah, that's it. I'm going to be enabling a head movement animation. That basically means that the model group name is head. That basically means that the entity is going to look at you, and I want that. Okay, so head, and yeah, we're pretty much done. First of all, let's see if it lags. No, it's not lagging. Okay. Go to the search bar and search Bob. It's going to be making a automatically it's going if you're making an entity, it's going to be making an a spawn egg as well. So let's see. Nice. So this is our entity. If we turn on, I think it's going to look at us, but I'm not sure. So you can see there's the walking animation, there's the idle animation, as you can see he's breathing. And can you do the, yeah, and that's the walking animation. So yeah guys, oh yeah, before I forget, I made it so he can drop items. So let's do that. Oh wow, look at him, he's trying to attack me. Did I make him? Oh wow, wow, wait. Oh nice. To tell you the truth, he's pretty worth it for diamond block. Yeah, this can be actually, oh wow, that can be a that can be a boss, to tell you the truth. Okay, so thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.